The arrange command in BricsCAD spatially organizes set of 2D or 3D entities by aligning or distributing them along the axis of the current UCS. This new arrangement of entities is defined based on the bounding boxes of the selected entities with respect to the selection bounding box. Bounding box of an entity is the smallest box which contains an entity. The gray rectangles in dashed lines indicate the bounding box. Similarly, the bounding box of a selection is the smallest box which contains all the selected entities. If I select all these entities, bounding box of the selection is indicated with this blue dashed rectangle. This command uses some bounds to create new configuration of selected entities. First, there are main bounds that are attached to the selection bounding box, and there are secondary bounds that are attached to the bounding boxes of each entities in the selection. Now let's launch the arrange command. I'll input arrange using the keyboard. Now I'm asked to select the entities to arrange. I'll choose these entities using a window. Give an enter. Next, you have to choose a direction, which is specified using X, Y, and Z axis of the UCS. When you choose an axis, the entities will only be moved along this axis. I'll click on X axis. Now you can choose from one of the 8 arrangement options. For example, the lower align aligns the lower bounds of the entities with the lower bound of the selection box. The lower bound is defined by the smallest coordinates along the specified axis. Now, let's try to understand this concept by using bounding boxes as references. Lower bounds of entities are indicated with these yellow dashed edges, and the lower bound of the selection set is indicated with this magenta dashed edge. When you execute lower align, the lower bounds of the entities will get aligned with the lower bound of the selection set, because the lower bound is defined by the smallest coordinate in the X direction. I'll click on lower align, and you can see that the lower bounds of the entities and the selection set is perfectly aligned. Now you came back to the same options to specify the direction. Now I'll click on X again, then I'll click on upper align. In upper align, the upper bounds of the entities and the selection set will get aligned. The upper bound is defined by the highest coordinate along the specified axis. I'll click on upper align, and you can see that the upper bounds are perfectly aligned. Now I'll click on X and none. In none option, the entity will not get arranged. If the arrangement is already done, the entities will be moved to the original position. I'll click on X again, then I'll click on center align. In center align, the center bounds of entities and the selection set will get aligned along the X direction. The center bound is located between the lower and upper bounds at the same distance from each of them. In this illustration, the yellow dashed lines indicates the center bounds of individual entities, and this magenta dashed line indicates the center bound of the selection set. I'll click on center align, and you can see that the center bounds are aligned. I'll click on X, then equally spaced. In this arrangement, the entities will get arranged in such a way that the gap between the entities will be of the same size along the X-axis direction. And that is clear from this illustration. You can see that the gap between these two entities and these two entities are the same. Now I'll click on X and lower equally spaced. In this option, the distance between the lower bounds of the consecutive entities will be the same along the X-axis. And that is clear from this illustration. The distance between the lower bounds of these entities are the same in the X direction. I'll click on X and center equally spaced. In this case, the distance between the center bounds of the consecutive entities will be the same along the X direction. And that is clear from this illustration. And you can see that the distance between the center bounds of the consecutive entities are the same in the X direction. I'll click on X again, then I'll click on upper equally spaced. In this case, the distance between the upper bounds of the consecutive entities will be the same along the X direction. And that is clear from this illustration. These are the 8 arrangement options in X direction. You will get the same options in Y and Z axis directions. Click on Y to arrange along the Y axis. Now I'll click on lower align. When I click on lower align, the lower bounds of the entities gets aligned with the lower bound of the selection set. The lower bound is determined by the smallest coordinate in the Y axis direction. In this illustration, the yellow dashed lines indicate the lower bound of the entities and the magenta dashed line indicate the lower bound of the selection set in the Y direction. In lower align, these two bounds will get aligned. I'll click on lower align and you can see the result. Now I'll click on Y again and the upper align aligns the upper bounds of the entities with the upper bound of the selection set. Upper bound is determined by the maximum Y coordinate in the Y direction. I'll click on upper align and you can see the result. In this illustration, you can see that the upper bounds of the entities and the selection set are aligned in the Y direction. I'll click on Y and center align. In this case, you can see that the center bounds of the entities will get aligned with the center bound of the selection set in the Y direction. Next, I'll move these entities in the Y direction. I'll click on Move command. Now I'll give Arrange command. Select these entities, click on Y, then I'll click on Equally Spaced. Give Enter. Now you can see that the distance between these entities is the same in the Y direction. And that is clear from this illustration. Then we have options like lower equally spaced, center equally spaced, and upper equally spaced. Each of these options are similar to what we have already seen in the case of X-axis. The only difference is that the arrangement is done along the Y-axis. You can also arrange entities in the Z-axis direction. In this case, we have 3D objects which are kept in different levels in the Z-axis direction. Now I'll give Arrange command and select these 3 objects, give Enter. I'll click on Z-axis. The lower align aligns the lower bound of each entity with the lower bound of the selection bounding box in the Z-axis direction. The lower bound is defined by the face of the bounding box placed at the smallest coordinate along the Z-axis. In this illustration, you can see the bounding boxes of the entities as well as the selection set as cuboids made up of dashed line types. I'll click on lower align and you can see that the lower bounds are perfectly aligned. Now I'll click on Z-axis again and I'll click on center align. Center align aligns the center bounds of the entities and the selection box, as we have seen in the case of X and Y axis. Now Z-axis again, I'll click on upper align. Upper align aligns the upper bounds of the entities and the selection bounding box in the Z-axis direction. Now I'll click on Z-axis again, equally spaced. Now the distance between consecutive entity will be the same in the Z-axis direction within the selection bounding box, which is clear from this illustration. Now you can see that the distance between these two entities as well as these two entities is the same. We also have options like lower equally spaced, center equally spaced, and upper equally spaced. Each of these alignment options are similar to what we have already seen in the case of X and Y axis. But in this case, these alignment options are applicable in the Z axis direction. This concludes the tutorial on Arrange command in BricsCAD V22. Thanks for your time.